Who said it's a man's world?
Hey, what's going on, everybody? This is Bree with Women Love Sports 2 Special Edition, and I want to thank all of you guys for tuning in. Of course, this is a special edition because we are still kind of getting used to being able to get our doors back open, so the studio isn't open yet for a full episode, but that didn't stop us because via Zoom, we're able to interview some amazing people, and I have someone amazing with me right now. This is Bobby, a.k.a. Mr. Black Jack himself from I-95 Sports. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you, Bree. Thank you for having me on the air. Appreciate your time.
Absolutely. And you know what? It looks so beautiful. Where are you located right now? You make me want to go outside right now. Just get some
right stuff. Right now, I'm in Elmwood Park, New Jersey. We're about 15, 20 minutes outside of New York City. Cool. So I'm right in the heart of everything here. This is where it all started, actually. It's my hometown. And I've actually, the past couple of weeks, I've moved a lot of my operations outdoors just so I can be out in the fresh air.
Awesome.
Been cooped up so long that I want to be at least be outside at least.
I know, right? Oh my goodness. And it looks beautiful. I'm in Southfield, Michigan. I like to say Detroit because a lot of people don't know Southfield area, but it's really beautiful outside as well. So it's just like, it feels good to finally be able to kind of get some fresh air, get out, soak up some sun. So
absolutely.
Yes. So about the I-95 Sports. So this is a streaming platform, correct?
Yeah, we've evolved. We started off doing the whole shebang kind of started with me and my cousin doing a show called Talking Football Live. It was a little internet radio program that we started, geez, almost 7, 8, 9 years ago, and it kind of grew into being its own sports network. When I realized that it was so so darn expensive to buy airtime, even for an hour show. Here in New York City, the New York City market, they're the biggest media market in the world. So I decided at that point, you know, just doing this one show, trying to get some traction, covering the New York Giants, Rutgers football, stuff like that, that, you know what, you know, instead of trying to pay for this airtime on a AM station in the middle of nowhere in New York City, why not start my own sports network? That's kind of how this all started back then. And so we went from doing the show called Talking Football Live to doing live audio broadcasts of the high school football team here.
Awesome.
And then just, you know, I soon realized that the trend and the way new media was going was towards video.
Yeah.
That's why I started doing the learning the whole live stream game. Yeah. And I built the whole platform on it, and now we're about to join a bigger platform that should be released. The press release should be coming out hopefully this week, where, you know, we're gonna be announced to be part of a bigger platform called For the Fan, and we'll be in front of 60 million households.
Wow!
With the I-95 Sports Network, yes.
That is absolutely amazing, and it's so many questions and so many things going through my head right now.
Sure, sure.
You said something so key, your own sports network. A lot of us sometimes strive to be on the ESPN, the FS1, NBC Sports, things like that. And with you creating your own streaming platform, what is one major advantage that you saw in creating your own platform? Obviously, outside of the cost that you were speaking of, what's another huge advantage that you saw with creating your own network?
Well, basically realizing that you mentioned ESPN, CBS Sports Network, stuff like that. They go after the big fish in the world.
Right.
But as you and I know, in the sports genre, there are different levels of pro sports,
right,
or pro-am or college or high school, stuff like that. That, you know, when I first started this 4, 5, 6 years ago, there were a lot of conferences, a lot of teams that weren't being covered. And now, if you notice, you know, they're trying to get their hands into everything. So we've kind of got a little jump start in doing stuff. So we've done everything from pro soccer to, we have pro soccer, we have pro basketball, college basketball, high school basketball, JUCO football, high school football, stuff like that. So the advantage is knowing and steering the business to where I want it to go, knowing where or areas that need to be covered by media, by live streaming, broadcasting, or whatnot.
Absolutely, and also getting out people who need to be seen. As we know, you and I both know, there are other people that don't have that outlet or platform to display their talents as well. You did mention mm-hmm. Pro-Am. So Pro-Am is definitely one of those. We have a lot of Pro-Am leagues and teams here out in Detroit. And not only that, but people like myself, women love sports too, getting started, wanting to do things on more than just maybe YouTube or other platforms. So I think that like that is so major, because you're putting on more than just, like you said, the big fish of professional sports. You're also helping out other people who may need that exposure.
Yeah, we're about to, once the press releases go out, hopefully this week, for this new platform, you know, we're going to really aim to be a more viewed and more known sports network. We have some people coming aboard that I can't name just yet that are just under the level of reporting you'll see on ESPN or platforms like that. So, you know, I'm building a team, I call it the dream team of, you know, the hungry people who are just below the precipice of that top level. And now we're going to build that up to be a very viable and, you know, successful organization.
That's amazing. And you did mention the professional sports. You did mention high school. Is it high schools across the country? Is it local high schools in your area?
Well, basically, I've perfected the use of the iPhone, which I'm on right now, or the iPad, to live broadcast sports. Especially indoor sports like basketball, for example. So, and I'm also the director of broadcasting for the Women's American Basketball Association, or WABA. So that has allowed me to have a platform where I can teach people remotely how to live stream basketball games.
Wow.
So by having that knowledge and experience and being at the forefront of the industry doing that, now I'm looking to build a team of broadcasters all over the country and beyond, where, you know, you might have a high school team in Idaho if you want to get going on I-95 Sports Network. You might have a semi-pro team in Mississippi. You know, now we'll have the ability of getting your team, your program on a bigger platform. That's the good thing about doing this.
Absolutely. And streaming, as we know, is the wave of the future, right? Everyone is turning, you know, mm-hmm. some people are what they call cutting the cord and moving away from cable to streaming platforms. And it's also yes. allowing us opportunities to see other talented people who have something to bring to the table, like yourself, mm-hmm. who have something to bring to the table. And just like, it sounds more like you're walking in your purpose, actually, because again, your purpose affects others that are around you. It's supposed to be like a trickle down effect, if you will. So it's definitely doing that as well. So that's absolutely awesome. In terms of just highlighting sports, you know, like doing live stream live sports, are there any actual sports shows that would be synonymous or, you know, similar to like a Sports Center or like a First Take or Undisputed, something like that?
Yeah, we're gonna have shows like that being developed for the various sports. Right now, most of the sports we have on I-95 Sports Network are general sports. Like we have, like I'll do a show and we'll be sending towards football. But I got shows like the K&K Sports Show, which covers everything. We have Beyond the Buzzer Sports, which covers basketball and all sports. And then we have, I guess the main thing is that we're going to have the general sports program like Sports Center, and we're gonna have individual sports covered. I think that's the key to a network like ours, like mine, is to, you know, have more sports specific programming. It's actually gonna find your niche audience and collectively grow together in different sports.
Yeah, absolutely. I think that's absolutely phenomenal. Now, with people who want, let's say, who may want to contribute, right, in terms of sports shows, or someone comes to you and says, hey, I got this great idea for a show and I would love for it to be on your network, how does that work at all? Are you looking to do that and implement that as well, or are you looking to just kind of continue to do more of an internal build, get it to how you want it, and then possibly welcome on others?
No, we're looking to expand. One thing you realize when you're running your own network, now also I have Blackjack TV, which is another network similar to I-95, except that's our entertainment arm for the most part. So one thing you realize in running your own streaming TV network is that there are a lot of hours in a day and a lot of hours in a week. So I welcome having new people come aboard and with their ideas and energy onto our networks to be creative, and you know, we give them the piece of art, so to speak, to do their own drawing and let them be themselves. So yeah, I'm always looking for new talent, new show concepts, new ideas.
Awesome. Now, what would you say is the absolute, like, hardest, most difficult part about having your own streaming network?
Well, I think in the beginning it was very tough because when I started covering teams like New York Giants or like Rutgers football or other teams in the area, you know, there's a lot of older media types who weren't really embracing new media. You know, this is going back maybe 3, 4, or 5 years ago. So when I finally got to the level of, say, going into the Giants locker room, for example, you know, there are people who wouldn't give me the respect or the, yeah, you know, or the time of day because who's this guy, right?
Right.
I write for Daily News. I write for New York Post. I write for Newsday. Who are you?
Right.
I'm on NBC News Sports. Who are you? Well, you know what? I'm starting to realize that, you know, as the sports and periodicals in general, like newspapers, are starting to fall,
yeah,
we're the thing that's pushing the industry back up. Like I said, new media, cutting the cord, stuff like that. So yeah, the toughest challenge was probably in the beginning where we had to like fight and claw for every ounce of respect we needed to get to realize we were a viable entity as far as sports media.
Absolutely, and I feel you 110%. You know, I'm climbing that ladder as we speak. So I absolutely understand where you're coming from when you talk about that. So that in and of itself is a whole nother beast. You know, you're like, okay, but the persistence and, you know, consistency with doing it and hanging in there is one of the key things, in my opinion, that pretty much can, you know, get you to that elevated, you know, where you want to be. So, like, I admire that tremendously. Outside of that, like, what would you say has been your greatest accomplishment so far?
I think greatest accomplishment being able to cover my alma mater. I'm a graduate of Seton Hall University, and we have a growing, viable men's basketball program. So being there for some of their biggest moments the past couple of years, you know, being in the locker room and creating friendships with some pro players. And when I was in the locker room, I always tend to seek out the up and coming players. Right, you're not going to get Eli Manning because all the big people want Eli Manning. There's always, in sports, everybody has a story. Everybody has a background.
Right.
And, you know, not everybody in the media wants to go towards the end of the roster, so to speak. So I kind of enjoyed, you know, actually becoming friends with some of the pro players that, you know, were, you know, kind of obscure when they first came into the league or whatnot.
That's awesome. That's absolutely awesome. And it's like, it's that one thing that gets your foot in the door, gets you, but you know, a little bit of notoriety, but it also helps to build a good relationship with those people as well, because you're recognizing those, like, as you said, people who are on the end of the bench, and you know, it makes them feel some kind of way like, oh man, they came and recognized me versus going to the superstar person or this and that. Like,
there's this one time, a real quick story. Me and my cousin were in a locker room. This is back in Talking Football Live days. So we're in the Giants locker room for mini camp, which is usually around this time of year, like May, after the draft, after the free agents get signed. And there was a player from Rutgers who I had covered in Rutgers football who was trying to make the Giants at that time. And we became very friendly, had a real good rapport. And we're waiting for him to, you know, talk to us. And one of the big sports anchormen from New York City sports tries to cut in front of us, and he goes, no, my guys come first. You have to wait till they're done, and then I'll talk to you. This guy was a much bigger name than we were at the time. That was pretty gratifying, you know, to see that respect that, you know, we were getting at, you know, at an early start.
Yeah, that's amazing. That is absolutely amazing. That's a story
for the first one of our cool stories we keep reminiscing about all the time. It's pretty cool.
Awesome. That is absolutely awesome. I love it. And if there's anything that you can have the viewers walk away with as it relates to I-95 Sports, what would it be?
Look out for us. We're going to be a entity, like I said, in 60 million households real soon. And, you know, I welcome the ideas and creativity of anybody. So if you want to become a part of the family, I'm Italian, so I consider everybody who's a part of my organization in the family. So including yourself, you want to become part of the family, you know, we will find a show for you. We will help you out. We will get you started. And I think one of the good things is that we're going to have people now who You know, I always thought it was a good thing to have, for us to be like a springboard for people to rise up in the sports media industry.
Yeah.
And now we're going to be not only we'll have that aspect, but we'll be a place where people can go and hopefully build a, even if it's a viable part-time job where you're making some money but having some good fun doing it, that's my goal of doing this. So if you have those ideas, you have those show ideas or teams you want to bring aboard to us, let me know. We're open ears.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. And I know I'm going to be on the lookout as well. I'll shoot anything that I have your way also.
We love it.
I'm doing mine right now, but I'm definitely going to do that. And this was supposed to be the part where I would ask for, like, the website and social media, but I actually had another question that popped into my mind.
Sure.
So as far as, are there any advertisements, like, in between, like, the games or the shows, like the live streams? If so, would it cost anyone anything if they wanted to bring the show on board? Like how that work? Like, I know with a lot of local networks or even larger networks, it usually would cost you something, right, to get on there, to get your shows up. So does it cost anybody anything? Is there anything monthly that they need to pay? Or
we're still working that out. When we were at the level we're at right now with the streaming stuff on Zingo TV and whatnot, we're thinking about it. But now, kind of like when a going back to my story about buying airtime on New York City radio, we're now going to have the ability to put you in front of 60 million households on this new platform. Oh, and also, kind of breaking news also, I'm also cultivating a whole different business model for this in India, second largest country in the world.
Wow.
So we're going to have that. So there might be something down the line where it might be a little fee to get involved, because you got to figure we're gonna put you in your program or your league or your team potentially in front of a huge potential audience.
Right.
So that there is some value to that as far as coming aboard. But no, then again, we're gonna be on a sponsored ad model for the most part. But you know, there might be right now there isn't. But who knows? We'll see how the next few months transpire, and especially once sports probably gets back to life, so to speak.
Yeah.
But you know, I would say, for the most part, right now there wouldn't be. But you know, I could see that potentially being something, only because of the value of putting yourself, or like I said, in front of 6 million households and growing. Yeah. And India is a whole other ballgame. That's, you know, there's a billion people over there.
Oh yeah.
Who love American sports, by the way.
Oh yeah, definitely they do. Yeah, and they, you know, so that's gonna be huge for anybody that's involved. Absolutely. Outside of the website, you guys, do you have an app, or do you plan on getting an app where people can watch it mobily?
On mobile right now, you can watch i95 Sports Network and Blackjack TV on the Zingo platform.
Okay.
Zingo TV. They have all the apps. They're on smart TVs, all the apps, all the devices, Roku, Apple, Amazon TV, whatnot. I 95 Sports Network is channel 198. Blackjack TV is channel 199.
Awesome.
And we might flip out our own app eventually, because yeah, we're going to have, you know, all different avenues and games going on at once. So it might behoove us to have an app for, you know, overflow and stuff like that.
Oh yeah, absolutely. And that way people can, like I said, like mobily, a lot of people usually are on the go, so a way for them to be able to watch. I watch a lot of stuff on my phone, a lot of YouTube on my phone typically if I'm not at home, so to be able to have that access when you're away from home will be major. So definitely when you guys get that super rolled out, let me know, because I'm definitely gonna download.
I will.
Everybody else to download for sure. And while we're on that topic, go ahead and just give everyone any of your social media information, the website, the platforms, and etc.
Sure. The website is i95sportsnetwork.com. Twitter, I am at Bobby Blackjack. Instagram, I'm Bobby_Blackjack. And i95 Sports Network on all three of them as well, I believe. I got to double check, because I have people doing stuff for me now, so.
Yeah, big time, big time.
Like, you're the boss now. We'll take care of this stuff for you.
Yeah.
I'll email you separately some of the links and everything, so you have them.
That's perfect. Absolutely perfect. Before we get out of here, I have a couple of rapid-fire questions. These have nothing to do with sports. This is just something to help people get to know you a little bit more, too. So, and sure. I'm interested as well. So, You are definitely in New Jersey. What is the best? I was literally watching Diners, Drive-Ins, and Dives, and I'm just like, oh my God, if I go here, I gotta eat here. If I go there, what is the best place to eat in New Jersey?
Wow. There's one thing that New Jersey is famous for. They call New Jersey and New York City is pizza. I think we have the best pizza in the world outside of Italy here in New Jersey.
Awesome.
Pizza is huge. And like I said, diners are actually based out of New Jersey. They're actually, I think we have the most diners in our state than anywhere else in the country.
Wow.
And diners, pizza.
I need to come out there.
Yeah.
Pay you guys a visit. It's warm.
Warm right now. I mean, it'll get right now. It's beautiful out, but yeah, we definitely have four seasons.
Oh yeah, for sure. I've been there during the winter, and I'm not coming back. Only in the summer.
I don't blame
you. Only in the summer. Oh my God, it has been such a pleasure to speak with you. I want to thank you so much for taking the time out.
Thank
to
you, Bri.
Here, absolutely. As you said, we are family, so we're going to be connected for sure. And again, you guys, I-95 Sports, make sure that you are tuned in because this man is doing a lot of amazing, amazing things. If you're interested in having your team or yourself, if you have shows, different things like that, you know, this is the guy that you want to get in contact with. This is the wave of the future here. So again, thank you so, so much. And I want to thank all you guys out there for tuning in to the special edition of Women Love Sports 2. Until next time, remember, guys, who said it's a man's world? Women Love Sports 2. I'll see you guys later.
Thank you.
Who said it's a man's world?